morning. Good morning, everyone. My name is Lysander Xanthus, and I would like to welcome you to the Morning Metaphysical Report. Today is December 7th, 2019, and it is a Saturday. So, during this Morning Metaphysical Report, I will be sharing with you the day's astrology, numerology, a card reading of the day, a crystal healing, and a reading that will help you manifest the life you want. Alright, so I would like to begin with a little energy clearing and setting an intention for the day. So now I'm going to send you a blessing for your day ahead. You are whole, happy, healthy, perfect, and complete. Today you will leave a little more behind what no longer serves you. You will embrace yourself a little more today. You will love yourself a little more today. Blessing your day ahead, that you experience greater success, good fortune, good experiences, and good company. And that holiday cheer comes to you during the day, making your step lighter and quicker. Blessed. All right, so first I would like to discuss the astrological reading for today. So the sun is in Sagittarius, so there is an emphasis on expanding our perspective. This is the part of ourselves and our lives that is being illuminated. What's being illuminated is the way that we look at things, and there's an opportunity to kind of go beyond how we've perceived things before. Let's see. It's a bit hard to tell. Looks like Jupiter is cusping, or it may actually be in Capricorn at this point. So we have Jupiter, Venus, Saturn, and Pluto in Capricorn. altogether, this can, I know some people are concerned, but really what it all comes down to is that all these influences are together bringing our attention and putting a very strong emphasis on any area of our lives in which we feel trapped or limited or stuck. and due to the planets involved, some of these areas include our relationships, especially romantic relationships, our perception of beauty, how we feel about ourselves. There's an emphasis on our home environment and home life, our relationships with our family, and with Jupiter also, I feel career opportunities and our own selves, our sense of self and our sense of our own progress. So if we're feeling like these areas of our lives are not what we want them to be, or we even feel trapped in the way things are, Capricorn asks us to mature and to grow up a little in acknowledging our responsibility and how our choices have led us to our present circumstance. The key to liberation and the power to transform comes in that. It also suggests that to go forward, to go beyond these limitations, you have to exercise that self-responsibility to be self-sufficient and independent, and it is up to you rather than waiting on other people to change, or for the situation to change, or for someone to come along and change you, or outer external things to change you. What?
I forgot to change the switchboard settings, so it says mini clairvoyant read.
Oh. Sorry, guys.
Just let everybody know that's not what it is, and maybe edit the description if it lets you. Sorry. Kitchen witches. Mistake. My mistake.
Oh dear. I don't know if it'll let me type in because it's been acting up for so long, but I can.
No. Just let everybody know. Sorry, guys. I messed up the description.
Not sure how to exit this screen, actually.
Well, as long as you can see everything.
This is very confusing.
I can't help you now. I don't know how you got this far.
Alright.
Just leave it. I just wanted you to let everybody know.
So this is not a reading video. Despite the Facebook description, I apologize. Okay, continuing with the astrology report. So, all that in mind. Mercury and Mars are still in Scorpio. This is giving us a push. It connects us to our feelings. So that it is a lot harder to ignore how we really feel and that we're influenced to act upon them. Neptune is in Pisces, so we have our deeper knowing and instincts kind of rising to the surface. And it is up to us how we'd like to integrate that information or not. Uranus is in retrograde in Taurus, so this is a time of reassessing our comfort zone and if we'd like to continue forward in this way. The moon is continuing to wax in Aries, so our attention is on the external world and out around us. We may be feeling that sense of initiative deep within, and the desire to act, and we are needing our energy to be directed and to feel like we are in control of our own lives. So that's the astrology for today. And now is the numerology. I apologize. I don't know why the sound would be lower than normal. I will try to talk more loudly. Because nothing has changed about the tech.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that is interesting, isn't it? For some reason, it doesn't seem to be.
Is there a mic setting on the camera?
I don't think so.
Because I did have to move it. Because when I did my video reading, it would only read from that camera. So I had to move it.
Sorry about the tapping. Is that a little better?
Is the sound any better like that?
Sorry, cupcake. My little cupcake, I'm sorry.
Alright. So, today is a 7 day. So, the 7 vibration seeks the truth. It's always asking the big question, who am I? It is a spiritual day, a day to be in nature, and a day to kind of be alone with one's thoughts. You should take time out today to study, learn, and seek the truth. Spend time on your own. Get with nature, the ocean, mountains, etc. If you're usually a big communicator, stay quiet and just observe. On the other hand, if you are normally quiet, this is the day to speak your mind. If you're troubled by a problem in your life, light a white candle, shut your eyes, and ask your inner voice what you should do. The answer will come to you. Alright. In just a moment, next is our crystal healing. And I'm very excited to show you these crystals. However, I do want to step away for 1 second. Just taking a moment to make sure she's okay. Alright, so I have for you today a red calcite and a shell fossil. So this is the red calcite. It's quite a large piece. And I am going to, I'd like to share with you the properties of it before we do the healing. So, red calcite is a stone that increases energy and willingness to experience life. It is grounding and protects energetic and emotional boundaries, alleviating spaciness and overexertion of one's energy. All calcite, I find, is a great healer and a great mover of energy. Let's see what we can learn about fossils. So there is ancient oceanic energy in this. And it is associated to healing, but I find that most things are. So if you would like to participate in this healing, all you need to do is sit, breathe, relax, and receive the energy. I'm going to be channeling the energy of these crystals to you one at a time. So that concludes the healing of the red calcite. So next I'll be using this fossil.
Thank you.
includes the healing with the fossil. Sorry, I don't know what's wrong with the mic, so I can't do anything about it. So next is the affirmation for today. So I'm going to say it to you two times, and then I invite you to say it along with me. So just take a moment to sit, and we will begin. Yes, I'm about to do the affirmation. I deserve to enjoy life. I ask what I want, and I accept it with joy and pleasure. You deserve to enjoy life. You ask what you want, and you accept with joy and pleasure. Now, let's say it together three times if you would like. I deserve to enjoy life. I ask what I want, and I accept with joy and pleasure. I deserve to enjoy life. I ask what I want, and I accept with joy and pleasure. I deserve to enjoy life. I ask what I want, and I accept with joy and pleasure. This affirmation comes from Heal Your Body by Louise Hay, and it is one of the spine affirmations. The spine represents all the ways that we are supported in life or not. So I found that most of us can use healing on all the issues that come up in relation to the spine, which is why I want to incorporate all those affirmations. All right. So in just a moment, I will be doing the card reading for today. Taking a look at the mic real quick. Yeah, really not sure what's going on with it. All right, so today's reading comes from the Nicoletta Ciccoli Tarot. So this is a general reading for you all as guidance for the day ahead. So the first card is the Empress. This card represents love and nurturing. So the message here is to take a closer look and to examine things. If you love others, you will receive their love in return. But mostly I find this as kind of like, it asks you to examine things and yourself and the way that you treat others for better or for worse. The second card talks about how loneliness can make it more difficult to see our way out of the darkness. And it advises us to get encouragement and guidance from others. So to not do it alone. The last card talks about a situation that is unstable and being on the alert for deception, but also to watch out for that in yourself and to not take shortcuts. So, this is kind of an interesting pairing, I think. See if the cards have anything else they'd like to say. This is the Wheel of Fortune. It is a reminder that all we do, cause has an effect. Every action has natural consequences that flow out from it, and that they can make us feel very trapped. But if you can realize how your choices have created that cycle, then you can choose something else and change your fate, as it were. Came out again. So I'm going to read the book description. The same card will flip out to emphasize its point or because something about it wasn't understood. So the description is, we are all at the mercy of fate. Don't struggle against your destiny. As time passes, the situation will improve. Changes in status, luck, and the cycles of time. There are a lot of different ways this card can be taken. And I feel as though that's all I want to say today. So, a bit cryptic, but I do think that there was something of value there. So, and now is the magic tip of the day. So, my magic tip is more kind of like magic advice for those of you who do practice magic and spell work, is to not feel like you have to do things a certain way, to be flexible and be open to of developing your own way of doing rituals and spell work. Read lots of different things, so you don't have to cast a circle and call the elements, but if that works for you, do it. I feel like we talked about this the other day, but it is important for those of you walking that path, just feel free to experiment and find your own way of doing things. A lot of the times I have heard from people that they feel bad or like they're not doing well or there's something wrong with them even because they aren't able to do things the way that supposedly everyone is doing them or the way that it's been taught it should be done. And that is a very unfortunate thing. So don't beat yourself up for not fitting into a box when it comes to magic or spirituality even. So on a broader scope, just because you don't fit the mold or fit the criteria doesn't mean that you're wrong necessarily. You're just finding your own way, and we're all unique. So there is no one way or one way of doing things. I'm kind of like blowing the incense smoke over here. So that is my real magic tip, is to be flexible and open-minded and be open to exploring who you are and finding a path and way of doing things that's in alignment with you. Rather than trying to make yourself fit a path, find a path that suits you. So, kind of a broad tip, but that is my tip for today. So next, we are going to be discussing how to manifest the things you desire into your life. And part of this is through a reading we've been doing. So, I have been reading excerpts from The Power Is Within You by Louise Hay, and we are reading through the chapter How to Love Yourself. And this is my second reading through, and after completing the chapter this time, I will be reading other chapters of the book because I feel as though there's excellent material there. So loving yourself is important for manifesting, as you have to, if you want to attract things into your life through law of attraction or magic, you kind of have to let yourself have good things. And when we don't like ourselves, sometimes we have a way of keeping good things away. Or even when we do get good things, we don't really let ourselves take them in. We hold out on ourselves. So we are actually on number 9 today. So this is a tip of how to love yourself a little more today. Number 9. I often emphasize the importance of mirror work in order to find out the cause of an issue that keeps us from loving ourselves. So reflection, digging deep. There are several ways that you can practice mirror work. I like to look in the mirror the first thing in the morning and say, I love you. What can I do for you today? How can I make you happy? Listen to your inner voice and start following through with what you hear. You may not get any messages to begin with because you're so used to scolding yourself. And you don't know how to respond with a kind, loving thought. If something unpleasant happens to you during the day, go to the mirror and say, I love you anyway. Events come and go, but the love that you have for yourself is constant and is the most important quality you possess in your life. If something wonderful happens, go to the mirror and say, thank you. Acknowledge yourself for creating this wonderful experience. You can forgive in the mirror too. Forgive yourself and forgive others. You can talk to other people in the mirror, especially when you are afraid to talk to them in person. You can clean up old issues with people. Parents, bosses, doctors, children, lovers. You can say all sorts of things that you would be afraid to say otherwise. And remember to end by asking them for their love and approval, because that is what you really want. People who have problems loving themselves are almost always people who are not willing to forgive, because not forgiving shuts that particular door. When we forgive and let go, not only does a huge weight drop off our shoulders, but the doorway to our own self-love opens up. People will say, "Oh, such a load has dropped off." Well, of course it has, because we've been carrying this burden forever. Dr. John Harrison states that forgiveness of both the self and the parents, coupled with the release of past hurts, cures more illnesses than any antibiotic ever could. Well, it certainly helps. It takes a lot to make children stop loving their parents, but when they do, it takes even more for them to forgive them. When we won't forgive, when we won't let go, we're binding ourselves to the past. And when we are stuck in the past, we cannot live in present time. And if we are not living in the present, how can we create our glorious future? Old garbage from the past just creates more garbage for the future. Speaking of manifestation. All right. Affirmations performed in front of a mirror are advantageous because you learn the truth of your existence. When you do an affirmation and you immediately hear a negative response within yourself, such as, "Who are you kidding? Can't be true, you don't deserve that," then you have received a gift to use. You cannot make the changes you want until you're willing to see what is holding you back. The negative response you've just discovered is like a gift in that it becomes the key to freedom. Turn that negative response into a positive affirmation such as, "I now deserve all good. I allow good experiences to fill my life." Repeat the new affirmation until it does become a new part of your life. I have also seen families change enormously when just one person does affirmations. Many people at the Hayride, a support group for people with AIDS, come from estranged families. Their parents literally will not talk to them. I've had them repeat the affirmation, "I have wonderful, loving, warm, open communication with every member of my family, including my mother," or whoever the problem person was. Every time that person or the family comes to mind, I suggest that they go to the mirror and say the affirmation over and over again. It is amazing to see the parents actually show up at the meeting 3, 6, or 9 months later. And so that is number 9, mirror work. Hi, love.
Hi, sweetheart.
You okay?
Anything? You okay?
I'm okay. Just gonna give my thoughts about what we read.
All right. Do you think?
It's just taking a moment to observe the comments on the various websites I'm streaming to. So, Louise brings up a lot of good points. So, her number 9 is mirror work. Use the mirror if it works for you. Otherwise, you can just kind of have a self-discussion. sometimes having the mirror in front of you and seeing yourself makes whatever you're working on more immediate. And it's really putting your issues in your face, so to speak. Having to look at yourself while stating affirmations or working on issues. Yes. So I'm just kind of reviewing what she talked about. Forgiveness is important. I do believe that forgiving yourself, you're the most important person you could forgive, and after you, probably, for most of us, our parents. And that forgiveness is an important key to improving your ability to manifest the life you want. I know that there are a lot of like things about forgiveness. So it's important to remember that forgiveness is for you and that it needs to happen in when you're ready. It's not something that you can rush or force. You can say you forgive someone or that you forgive yourself, but it's not real or complete. It really is like a knot coming undone or a weight falling off of you when you've really gotten there. And it's like when you really have done it, the people or thoughts that used to bother you, you don't really feel anything about them anymore. And it's just like this huge block of bitterness that's kind of moved out of your path. So forgiveness doesn't condone what happened or what the other person did. It's a gift for yourself so that you are no longer weighed down and tied down and held back by what someone else did. Unfortunately, it's very human, but it's really just like punishing ourselves for something someone else did when we hold on for so very long. So it's just something you have to find a way to reconcile with yourself, and it's a gift for you. And always remember, forgiveness should be for you, for your own peace. And it is so true. You should say your affirmations to the mirror at least one time, mostly because it really does have a quick, sharp way of bringing up any negative thoughts you have and association to what you're trying to create for yourself. And it clearly shows you where your blocks are and your areas for healing are. So it is very helpful, even if it is distressing or difficult to deal with. So those are my thoughts. If anyone has comments, I invite you to share them. If anyone has questions about something we've discussed during the report or something that's just on your mind, I invite you to ask it. I'd also like to let you all know that my inbox is always open, so you can direct your questions there. If you enjoyed this morning report, I suggest that you like, follow, or subscribe to my page on Facebook, Lysander Xanthus, or to my channel if you're watching this elsewhere, so that you can keep seeing this every morning, as well as all the other content I produce on Facebook. All my other content is on Facebook. So if you like and follow my Facebook page, you will also see all of my reading videos. I do clairvoyant and tarot readings. You will see my live Q&As, speaking of which, there is one today. At noon Mountain Standard Time, I am holding a live Q&A about preparing for the new year, so leaving behind 2019 and stepping into 2020. We're going to be discussing a lot of different things. If you decide to join me for that, I suggest that you bring a journal or something to write with. Mostly it's more for like personal journaling exercises. I also do 2 moon rituals a month, one on the new moon and full moon. Also, I have a Patreon. It is patreon.com/freedomdreamcoaching. Normally that link is in the description. So I'm going to type it in the comments for anyone who would like to check that out. It's information about me, my fiance who's the kitchen witch, what's behind this report. And it will tell you about what goals we're striving towards, how you can support us in that and grow with us. And you do receive perks and rewards in return for your supports. Depending on your level of monthly subscription, that does include weekly or monthly free readings. All right, so am I forgetting anything? I'm just taking a moment to think if I'm forgetting anything. Well, we talked about, we did the reading. If anyone has questions about manifesting, you can ask that. That does remind me, I am writing a Manifest Your Life webinar, which will only be available through my Patreon. You won't be able to catch it anywhere else, at least at first. I may try to find a way to host it. However, you'll still have to purchase attendance. I think that's it. I hope you guys will join us on Patreon. You can create an account and follow our page for free. There's some free content there. I hope that you'll like and follow my page so that we can keep seeing each other in the morning as well as other times. And I hope that you guys will join me for the live Q&A about the new year. It does include readings about the year ahead, and I will be discussing the New Year's reading package that we will be offering.
There he is.
Can we see the cats? We haven't had a cat segment in a while.
Oh no!
This is little putty pies!
Oh no, it's okay, honey.
You're being very fussed.
It's okay.
Oh, we were happy with mommy. I ruined it.
Were we happier with mommy?
We were. I ruined it. Here's the other one. This is Arushka Gull. She was on the opening screen as Christmas Cat.
She is Christmas Cat. She's the most beautiful lady. Very healing baby. Yes. Everybody say hello.
She's done.
All right, come here.
Come here, baby. Oh.
All right, well, I hope you all have a wonderful day. And I really hope I see you all again. Thank you, everyone, for watching today and joining me. I'm going to send you some last healing vibes. All right. This has been the Morning Metaphysical Report. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you all again soon.